Hey guys, it's Paige and I'm back with another video today. So today we're gonna do an unboxing of a new handbag that of course I'm sure you're already gonna know from the title. So we're gonna get straight into the unboxing, but like always, I do want to say thank you for everybody who's watched my videos, who's liked, commented, and subscribed to my channel. Make sure you give this video a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button. We're gonna get straight into this unboxing. So I am very happy because I've been wanting a handbag for a long time and I finally have it. So hopefully there's no problems with this package and I will finally have this handbag in my possession. I ordered this from a department store called Vitcac. This is my first time ordering from them. It was a whole like fiasco, not with this retailer, but just in general with another retailer trying to get this bag. I'll leave a card to the last vlog I did where I talked more about that. All right, so this is my invoice and receipt, I guess. The package comes like this with pretty nice packaging. You just can't see everything because I have the camera too well close. And it comes in tissue paper. And this is the bag. And it comes in a Balenciaga dust bag. And there it is. I finally have it. I've been wanting a Hourglass bag for the longest time. And I'm glad that I finally got it and found it in a color that I wanted. I did a video on my whole dilemma on that, so I'm also gonna leave a card for that. But I really wanted the camel color, but I just waited too late to get that, so I couldn't find it in the camel color. And finding this bag here was very difficult as well because it's not in stock on the website. And I couldn't really find it anywhere else. Aside from Set Tire, I tried to order it twice, but it was out of stock after I placed my order. So this is a small Balenciaga Hourglass bag. The bag comes with a shoulder strap that is adjustable. It's not very long, I can tell already, because it's on the last one. So I don't know that I will be able to, I mean, I guess I could wear this as a crossbody, but I'm gonna put the straps on. All right, guys, I'm really struggling to get these straps on. I think it's because of my nails and I'm kind of strapped for time. So I'm gonna insert mod shots with this on me so that you can see how it sits on me. Keep in mind that I'm 5'9", so I'm on the taller side, so it will look different if you are shorter than me, but it's adjustable, so you'll always be able to adjust it. So this bag is in the color light beige. I really hope that my camera is not washing this out, and I feel like it might be. It's probably not helping that I'm wearing cream. Let's see if it'll focus on the bag so that you guys can see the details, but it is the mock croc. The color is called light beige. It's really a cream. It's just a cream bag. The hardware is gold, of course. I really like that combination together. So I was really looking to fill gaps in my wardrobe. So I wanted either a cream bag or just like a tan, like the camel color version of this bag. And because they discontinued it, it was just really difficult for me to figure out what bag I wanted to get this year. and to actually find the bag that I actually like in a color that I liked. So I got this for myself for a birthday present, but also for just, I guess you could say, a graduation gift and to just commemorate graduating from law school this year, taking the bar exam, God willing, passing the bar exam, and just like this new chapter of my life. I try to make purchasing luxury handbags special to me because out of all luxury, I love handbags the most, and I really like remembering back to like the time in my life or like the good things that happened the year that I bought a bag. So I just really like to put like a lot of thought into getting bags. Handbags generally aren't impulse purchases for me unless it's something that's like a crazy sale on something and there's like a huge discount, then I just really try to keep them special. So I put a lot of thought into this and I'm really happy that I finally got my hands on it and I was able to get it in the color that I wanted. So the price on this bag recently went up about like $50 or $100. So this bag right now retails for $3,000 for the small in the mock croc. It's still cheaper if you just get the regular smooth leather. And the prices vary depending on what type of leather you get or material the bag is. Not only was I able to find this bag in the color that I really wanted, but I was also able to find this bag for a really good deal. So I saved, like including taxes and duties and all of that, I saved like $1,000 on this bag. Which I'm really excited about because that just makes it even more special for me. The trade-off of not getting it from Balenciaga directly is that I don't have a box, but I still have that black box, but I don't have like a Balenciaga box, but I'm not about to pay $1,000 just for a box. I normally prefer just buying it from the designer, or like from a US retailer, ideally, especially if I'm paying full price, but I'm really happy that I found this for a great deal. So this is what the bag looks like in the inside. That's just a Balenciaga tag. It has one zip pocket in the inside and it's just one, big space. Well, it's really not that big. You can fit a phone in here. Again, this is a size small and I could actually like lay it flat at the bottom. So it's not the roomiest bag in the world. I don't feel that this is like the most functional bag either. So I don't think this would be like a great everyday bag. But it's big enough for what I want to use it for. This pocket does expand a little, if you could see right here. So that's a plus. And then it just has this slip pocket in the back right here that I, let's see if you can, I don't know that I would stick my phone in here. It won't fit with my pop socket on there, but I'm sure you probably could. You know, stick a phone in there or receipts or something like that. I have never had a white bag before. I don't know that I'm ever going to get a white bag, but I would love to have a white bag. I just don't know that I will get one because I would just really be afraid about getting it dirty, and I'm not sure that I'll actually really enjoy the bag. So this was kind of like my compromise, getting a cream bag, because hopefully if there are like marks on it, then hopefully it'll be a little bit more forgiving. But I do think most things will probably wash off of this, or you could rub it off since it's coated. So I don't know, hopefully that works in my favor. The other reason why I wanted cream too is because I know that I'll be able to wear it all year round. So if I have a white bag, I'll be kind of restricted to using it in the summertime or spring and summer. And cream, you can wear all year round. So that really was the main reason that I opted for cream instead of white. So I was finally able to get the strap on the bag. So I'm gonna show you guys some mod shots now. So this is the bag on me, which actually I kind of like it like this. I wouldn't mind adjusting it and wearing it a little bit higher, depending on like what I was wearing and where I was going. I kind of like that look now where top handle bags, like the Jacquemus bags, that kind of like sit up here when you wear them as a crossbody. So I like that I have like that option, but I feel like this sits like at a nice length for me, considering that I'm tall. I really like that a cream bag is like, it's a neutral, but it's also unique because you don't see a lot of people walking around with a cream bag. And I just also love how unique the shape of this bag is. Balenciaga does like a lot of things that I really don't like, but they also do a lot of things that I do like. And the Hourglass bag is definitely one of those things. Even though I don't know that this bag is a classic, right? Or I don't know that it's always gonna be something that is in style, that people are gonna be wearing 20 years from now. I know that I will enjoy this bag for a long time. And I just, it's something about it that I really, really love. And every time I see it, it just makes me excited. So that's why I chose to get this bag. And of course, you can just wear the bag in the crook of your arm and put the strap either in the bag or just leave it, depending on how you plan to wear it. I like having both options. I think if I were going somewhere where I wasn't gonna do like a ton of walking, like maybe to like a dinner or a brunch or just going out for the night, then I probably would just wear it without the strap. But if I were going to like a mall or somewhere where I know I'm gonna do a lot of walking or have to like carry things or need both hands, I probably would wear both. I also think this color really translates to like daytime and nighttime pretty well. I'm pretty sure that I will wear this more in the daytime than nighttime, but I'm just really happy to have a different color handbag in my collection. Another up close shot of the bag in case that other footage is washed out and you can't really see the details. It's, to me, it looks a little smaller in person than what I kind of anticipated. But it's the perfect size for me. I don't think that I would buy this bag twice, but I just don't know if I want to invest that much money in Balenciaga Hourglass bags, but I definitely wouldn't mind having a extra small one, or getting like the Balenciaga shoulder bags, like the kind of like clutch bags or wallet on chain. I love that too. So that is all I wanted to show you guys for today. I will come back later on at some point, I'm sure, and give you guys an update on this bag. Tell me what you guys think about the Balenciaga Hourglass bag. Do you think it's trendy? Do you think it's something that's gonna stay here or stay around for a while? Do you have a bag like this? Let me know in the comments, or if you have experience with this bag, let me know in the comments below. Make sure you give this video a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye.